two people join a company. A man joins a company and a woman joins a company. And they both get the plate, you know, as in my plate is full. And so one day, the guy looks at his plate. It's the same size plate. It's a standard size plate, right? And he looks at his plate and he goes, oh God, oh my God, my plate is full. So here's what he does. Hi, Debbie. How you doing? Yeah. You're back from vacation, huh? Yeah. Good, this is for you.
Thank you.
Dr. Moore, you're one of the best doctors here. You know what? They told me you do this better than anybody. Laura, nice blouse. Is that a new hairdo? Gosh, it's so great to see you back from vacation. Here, this is for you. Goes around, he delegates. So he has some room on his plate. Now, remember that room on his plate, because before the day is over, I will share with you what he uses it for. It's very, very important aspect of leadership. He's making room for leadership there. A woman. She also started at the same time, right? She looked at her plate at about the same time and she goes, oh my God, my plate is full. So she gets a turkey platter and she starts walking around with this turkey platter, right? And everybody she knows says, look, there's lots of room on her plate. Her kids put stuff there, her family puts stuff there, the community puts some more things there, all the people in the company, her direct reports even put stuff there, because this is one of the little insidious ways that your direct reports get you to report to them. They go, well, you know him better than me. Would you call him and let me know? Or, I didn't get it done because I'm waiting for your response to my email. What? Didn't you get my voicemail? That means you're reporting to them. See? So now your plate is so full, and it's a turkey plate, your back is breaking. And I lived this recently. I have this client at JP Morgan Chase, and we were having a meeting. And every time we had these meetings for a project, she would say, oh, Yvonne, I got more responsibility. I was so happy for her. I was so proud of her. Young, what, 32 maybe, 34? The third time she said, oh, I got more responsibility. I was really happy for her because she was so thrilled. Then one day, I called up for our meeting. Well, she wasn't there and they were all acting cagey, you know. You know, you can hear it over the phone. You're going, something's going on. And being Yvonne Brown, I had to get to the bottom of it. So I looked and followed up, and what I found out is this beautiful young woman got a brain aneurysm right in the conference room. Dropped to the floor. Took her straight to the hospital. They had to put her in a coma. My understanding is that's how they get the swelling in your brain to go down. And what do you guys think is the first thing she said when she came out of that coma? Who can tell me? Something about work, that's true. What did she say? She asked, is everything okay? And she said, where's my laptop? I've got work to do. And they wouldn't give it to her. And by the way, the project completed successfully without her. So when you delegate, you're supposed to delegate for more than one reason. One reason is you delegate so that you can bring your people along, grow other leaders, and give them some opportunity to increase their skills. And also to give yourself that space on your plate that I'll tell you what to use it for later on today.